Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming to share with you a few travel journals or travel folios. Many of you already know that I set up for myself Patreon page, and I would like to say a huge thanks to all of you who are already in there. Thank you so much for all your support. And for my Patreon, I decide to do like my first tutorial, something what I like, the type of journals I like, and it's this one. This is actually a journal I made in that Patreon. I just had to switch disclosure. I had to swap it because it wasn't really what I wanted. So these journals are like books I like. You can slide so many papers in those journals. Here you can slide some full, maybe drawing journal with those watercolored papers. And there is another sliding spot are inside. So I'm gonna move those on the side and I will show you one by one. I create also all these backgrounds. They are made from old Atlas book, which I had here in my stuff. So I create all this. It was proper new book. All these pages was kind of nice, like this book. And I, from book pages like this, I try to create something what is looking vintage without using gesso and all that stuff, because I don't like that crumpling when you use gesso and those paintings. So I used my own technique. And when you open it, we've got pocket here. It's large pocket here. And then is this beautiful photo frame. I've got here a few those mini pockets. They are, I think, in the journal as well. Then is this elastic band, which can hold two journals. Here we've got like tuck spot, belly band. And here is that file folder section. And I made it the way where you can also slide some papers or sewn some papers. I made stitching here, not stitching, holes here. And in those holes you can easily sewn your papers or anything you want. Here we've got pocket. And here is like tuck spot. So I add here this train travel photography. When you open it, we've got large pocket here with tag and with this small mini folder. And that mini folder, it's like pocket, and also here is small tag spot. All this is in that tutorial. It was terrible tutorial. not so good one. And here we've got pocket in that envelope. Here is like mini pocket. Also how to do those labels you can find in that tutorial. And here is first signature I sewn in those spots, in those holes in there. Here we've got another large pocket. And here you can see these are those index pages from my Atlas book, which I a little bit distressed and recreate. This is made from a new cover from book. I also showed that in my tutorial. And it's pocket here, again, like belly band here. And it's pocket in that mini folder. And it's like tuck spot here. And also it's pocket here in that envelope. We've got beautiful photography, this one. And when we turn it over, we've got frame here. That frame, it's like cover for large envelope, so you can save there so many things you want. Here is another pocket, and here are two teeny mini small like tuck spots. And this is like frame, and here is another very beautiful picture from train travels in that 19th centuries, how beautifully those trains looks at that time. You can also slide some tuck or something here if you will want so. Here we've got belly band. I used for that belly band. This is Tim Holtz die, that film strip die. And here you can see how I changed all these maps. They are still there, but not too much. They kind of vanished. And it's like belly band. And we've got, again, I think it was here, right? It was here. Yeah. Again, this teeny mini pocket with a pocket, or tap with a pocket. So you've got journaling space here, journaling space here. You can put there maybe picture or some notes, and you've got pocket here. And it was hanging here, I believe so, like this. Here is that belly band. On that other side, we've got opening frame with this lady, traveling lady. It's in this frame. And it can be open. And here I've got just this ephemera and this envelope. And it can be open like this. So you've got very large pocket here. And also it's pocket here from that other side for something. Here you've got journaling section, journaling section, journaling section. You can put some picture here and write about that picture down there, or different way. You can store there your ephemeras, your findings, tickets from, I'm not sure, from train, from maybe theater, from cinema, anything you want. And it's hanging behind these strings, or what is it, trims. Like this. And it's small tuck spot here on a backside of that frame, and close it with this tab. And we've got another openings here. This is space for some pictures. It's also from those old book pages, all those maps. Here is large space for journaling. Here we've got another frame, and I've got there this lady, traveling lady. When we open that frame, here is like tuck spot or a small pocket. And here you can see another, that page from my Atlas book, and it's large pocket behind. Here I've got this ephemera and one letter. So this is my first travel journal. I made a full tutorial on my Patreon. And now I'm gonna show you those address. They are kind of similar that those journals before I showed you. I didn't show you yet, but those other journals, they was like before I made tutorial for this one. I had to find a way what I would like to show you, and you will see that I've been inspired by, oh, I forgot, not yet, here are still pages. So you can still add, you know, to these holes, you can still add some pages, you can still sew inside something what you like. Maybe even some booklets, some leaflets from place you're gonna visit. Where I stuck? Oh, here I stuck. So it's this journal. And this journal, it's still for sale, because it's last one I made and I forgot to place it on my Etsy. So it will be there soon. And it's hanging, it's closing with this elastic band, because I found myself that those elastic bands, they are probably the best way how you can close your journals which you want to add, which you want to fill with some goodies, with some ephemeras, with some memories. And this was, I think this large one was first I made. Yeah, this was first I made. Here I made closing using this frame. And it's hanging on the backside on those elastic bands. Here you can see another page from that Atlas book. And when you open it, we've got pocket here with this small pocket. And it's like journaling space there. Pardon me. And it's made from that, I think you call it that Franklin paper. When you glued together all your scraps. Here I've got just vintage card and small tag. We've got pocket here in this envelope, and I've got there this ephemera, and we've got pocket here again with card. It's behind that beautiful picture. It's picture from book. When we open it, we've got here large pocket with teeny meeny small notebook. I do not have tutorial yet for this teeny mini small notebook, but I will do it for YouTube as well, this one. It's again from old map. I just backed that old map with normal paper, and then I made small notebook, like that pocket notebook with envelope, with pockets. Here I've got again cards. So, another space for journaling. And it's pocket here, so you can save there so many things, maybe from one day trip, where you don't want to take all, you know, all that journal, so you can take just this small one. And it's closing just with this long thread. Thread, is that the right word? And it looks like envelope, so if you will seal it here, you can send it actually somewhere to someone once you will finish your journal. And here we've got again hanging behind those elastic bands two signatures with different types of papers. And when we open it, we've got very large space here for journaling and for saving ephemeras and for all that kind of funny stuff. And as you can see, the first journal was totally inspired by Tim Holtz file folders. I thought I'm gonna show how to create them, but then I was thinking that that's stealing. That's stealing just this idea. I have to do something mine. Therefore, I create that different type of editing pages and ephemeras. This here I use Tim Holtz die to create small booklet, to decorate this small booklet. So lots of space for journaling. It's pocket here in that both. Here I've got just this beautiful picture. Some pictures will you know, repeat. Here I've got pocket, and here again this, I take all that inspiration, I create again that belly band. I created here first time, and then I copy that in those journals because I like this style of belly band. You can still see what you've got there because of those frames. And here again that envelope, this time is decorated like travel envelope. I've got here this picture, again that lady, pocket, and here is pocket, here is small booklet for journaling, and you can open it here, and it's space for journaling here. So it's a little bit different way decorated, and it's made from one envelope, all this. So I think I maybe will do a tutorial for this one as well. When we open it up, oops, I have to move this. When we open it up, this one, we've got very large pocket here. It's just that string pocket, very large pocket here for saving some memorabilia, some booklets, some trip advisors, you know, those all kind of magazines. Here we've got small pocket with those tags. Here we've got large pocket with this ledger paper. And here I just back it with all kind of my scraps, and then I stamp it with different type of stamps. Here I've got just again that train travel from 19th centuries. You can find so many beautiful pictures on Google. If you will type train travel on the 19th centuries, you will find them there. So it's here. When we flip it over, oh, I forgot this lady. Come here, my little lady. When we flip it over, we've got small pocket here, large pocket there, and again that old maps, book pages. All these pages are from that new book with maps. And here is like pocket. Here we've got another section with pockets, pockets, pockets. It's like all this. It's one large pocket, but I made it like frame because I like the decoration. Here again, that booklet, this picture, and again, Tim Holtz die. And I made another opening journaling space. So it's here. When we flip it over, we've got here this one. It's multi-pocket book. It's three pockets, lots of space for saving your ephemeras. Here you can glue your photographies, and it's like belly band here on this first one. It's like belly band here, and I used again that old map book, and I stamped it a little bit. So it's booklet here. I didn't put there anything because I hope that new owner, Vani, thank you so much for buying this one. That was so fast. I hope you will receive that very soon, and I hope you will like it. I really hope you will like it. We've got teeny meeny small pocket here. It's nothing inside. It's just for your your ephemeras, your notes, your quotes, anything you want. Here, just small tuck in this one, in this teeny, mini, small pocket. Here is very large, from this way. It's very large pocket here, space for maybe pictures or for some notes, you know, to glue there some notes, again here. And here I've got two small frames. This is, by the way, it's Sizzix die, I don't remember name, I think it was 3D frames or 3D cards, something like this. And I've got picture here, this one, and it's like small booklet, yeah. It's like small booklet for journaling. And here I've got that traveling lady on camel. And when we flip it, here we've got like tuck spot, and I've got there this ledger paper, and when you flip it over, you've got space for photographies. Here we've got large envelope with many pockets. Here two window mini pockets, large pocket behind with this, again another beautiful picture from train travels, ledger paper, and very large envelope pocket here. And it's another opening. So it's filled with so many envelopes and pockets. And here you can see again that belly band using Tim Holtz film strip die. Here is pocket, very large pocket, very beautiful large space where you can place anything you want, some notes, and again this envelope. It's same like that before. So it's this journal. And oops, go there. Flip it back. So this was totally inspired by Tim Holtz folios, but I was thinking so hard how I can change it, how I can show something mine, some my own design. So therefore I changed that. So this is for Vani. Here I've got for for Janet. I hope that Janet will like it as well. This is for Janet. So Janet, thank you so much. Thank you so much for buying my creations. I really hope you will like it. Here I chose Eiffel Tower, and again it's closing, holding on this elastic band. I used Eiffel Tower on the front. I put here a few embellishments. Here we've got pocket behind that Eiffel Tower with small tuck. Here, this can be used also for sliding something behind, but it's more like an embellishment here. Here we've got pocket, and here is a small tuck spot, or belly band. And I've got there this ticket, with this small ticket, and again, that vintage travel, that train travels. I used some stamps here, and again, those book pages, old maps, Not old, but maps now looks old. And here we've got again that frame. I like that frame here. It's, you know, you can put there some picture from your holiday, and you can add behind some basics informations. Here again that envelope I showed you before. Here loads of space for your notebooks, for another papers you want to add there. And when we open it, we've got pocket here, like small pocket here with another beautiful picture from trains in the 19th centuries. I love these trains. I wish they are now now on those rails. What is it? Because I would love to travel with something gorgeous like this. It looks like, you know, those pictures from Titanic, from the boat. So they look exactly same, very, very comfy and very posh. So I really love those pictures. And here you can see that my changing for those file folders. Here we've got large pocket with this envelope again. Here I create, this is the sliding slide effect. So you can add some pictures here or some journaling and slide it back. It's that. Oh, I think I did it too tight. Here is pocket with another beautiful picture. Oh, didn't I put the same? I did. I have to change that picture. Okay, I will put there some different one. And we've got this ephemera here, just small writing space. It's in this pocket here, and it's pocket behind as well, with this sign and with small tag for writing. It's behind. And when we flip it over here, I create like cross for holding any kind of tags and writing spaces. Again, traveling picture from train travel, again tag, and it's holding behind those what is it? Threads, probably. This cross thread. Thread cross. And again, here, because of these holes, you can sew them so many another papers, so many another journals, if you wish so. Here I've got, is it pocket? Yes, it is pocket from the top. So it's large pocket for loading anything. Maybe it will hold even another journal. I think I made it very long. Very long, very deep. I believe I made it very deep. Yes, it can fit another journal. So if you will have some small journal, this is actually very large journal, so you can fit it in this pocket. It's pocket from this side, and here another my changing new papers. This is actually, I used this. I'm gonna show you what I used. I used covers from these, like ledger papers, from these new ledger papers. So I used that cover for creating this pocket and for making it so vintage. So it's in this pocket here. Here is another holding for something you would like to keep there. When we open it, it's large space for journaling. This can be open, and it's pocket here, Visit Britain. It should be there, you know. Pardon me. Again, this I like this lady. You know, she looks very happy, and she looks like she's standing on one of these wagons, those open wagons. So that's why I add her here, because it looks like, oh, she was traveling really weird way. She's so brave. And we've got pocket here with this ephemera, and pocket behind with this beautiful picture, beautiful letter. So this is for Janet, and I really hope she will like it. I hope you will like it, Janet. I really hope you will like it. So this is another journal, and the next one is this journal. It's for Aileen. Thank you so much, Aileen. You put my creation. I had to swap a little bit again. Holding that elastic band, I had it here around, but because I used very hard, very strong elastic band. It wasn't good enough, and it was sliding. So, because I think she will maybe hopefully fill this journal with some goodies, with something she likes, I had to make it this way because it will hold that journal properly. So I add again a few embellishments here, some charms, this star, because girls, you are my stars. I think, yeah, I destroyed my pocket here with this eyelet. But we've got pocket here with a London. I've been visiting London a few days ago, and we had to borrow a car for that visiting. And it was much more bigger than my own car. And when I parked first time on service, on motorway service at 6 o'clock morning, I'm so glad it was so early because no one was there. Just three cars around us. Nobody else was there. And I did park on two spots. That was terrible. It was never happened to me before. And I was so surprised when I went out of that car and I saw that. I was like, oh mine, what I did. So here you can see another those map pages. And when we open it, yeah, here, many pockets here. There. When we open it, we've got, this is like Polaroid frame. Maybe you can slide some picture behind. And it's pocket behind, like tuck spot. Here I've got just small embellishments, you know, using my scraps and dies. So I slide them here to that frame. Here I've got, I love these acetate pieces, so I tried, I don't have that shrink paper, and I was thinking if I will use normal acetate, maybe I can shrink it to that small. It didn't work, so those rest stamps I just cut to those small pieces, it's in shape like folder or that divider, and I place them in my journals, and it's beautiful, beautiful letter. Vintage letter. So it's here behind this pocket. Here we've got that envelope I showed you before in that large pocket behind. Again, papers for journaling, and it's so many space to add there another papers. When we open it, we've got here what I just lost, I think. I lost paperclip. Here we've got a Eiffel Tower. This is picture from 19th, what was that? World Exposition, I think. And it's pocket behind with this ledger paper tag. And you can flip it like this. You've got space for journaling. You've got beautiful ephemera here. And here it's another that pocket with tuck spot and with pocket here, my altered card for your journaling. So I'm gonna hang it back again on this small tag like this. And we've got pocket here with this ephemera. And this was, I think, second journal I made. It was still inspired by Tim Holtz with his beautiful journals, with his beautiful folios. But then I was changed that. And we've got pocket here, large pocket here, again made from those old maps, not old, why I'm saying old, because it looks old now, from those maps, book pages. Whew. And here we've got pocket with another beautiful paper. Look at those. I love those letters. They look stunning, stunning. They are so gorgeous. So it's here in this pocket, and it's still space for editing more. That pocket has window from that other side. And here we've got again that belly band. Here I've got a little bit different pocket. I was playing with my envelope, so I made pocket like this. Here is pocket for some goodies, and here we've got pocket for some goodies. Here you've got a writing space, and it has window, so you can actually see what you've got inside if you will have something inside. So it's in this small envelope. And we've got this traveler. It's a cabinet card. It's behind this belly band. Again, that Tim Holtz belly band. Tim Holtz film strip. When we flip it over, we've got again that large envelope. Here we've got a tax pot with this ephemera and large ledger paper, again with my Franklin paper, and here again that map, altered map. When we flip it over, we've got a little bit different way. This is opening here. We've got journaling space here. Space maybe for picture. Here is opening. And pocket here. When we close that from here. Close it. Close it. We can flip it over and we've got journaling, not journaling, journaling space here. And here, this one, it's like tuck spot, like this. So you can glue some ephemeras, maybe some pictures on those spaces. And here we've got another, that teeny mini booklet, pocket, secret pocket. Here, it's hanging on this pocket. And here I've got another one with this spot. Again, that altered book cover. It's hiding here. Here we've got large pocket, not large pocket, envelope pocket with small window. Here I've got again that Tim Holtz globe die, like journaling space. Again, that envelope, it's holding here in this pocket. When we flip it over, we've got sliding space here, so you can even slide some papers here and you can have a little bit more spaces for journaling. Here I've got, I made from map books, not map books, map pages, I made this envelope. So it's here, very large space for saving all kind of your notes and those booklets and you know, those maybe receipts from restaurants you're gonna visit. And here we've got large pocket behind and those two small window pockets. Here we've got opening here, so you've got, you can see what you've got that in the pocket behind. And here we've got small envelope with tag, and in that pocket behind we've got this one. It's like library, library pocket with my tag, with my traveler's tag, with space for journaling behind. So these are my traveler's journals. Few of them inspired, all of them inspired by Tim Holtz, but a few of them changed my way. I hope you like them. I hope you took some inspiration. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, guys, for all your amazing support. It's really wonderful, especially now in those days. I can't thank you enough. I've got, again, a very crazy time in my life. It looks like I have to change my job. I will have to change my job because I'm not getting paid properly. And because of that, I couldn't get to my job. It was really bad time, so I think, and because I couldn't get to my job, I will have there now absences, which for those days I will probably get the disciplinary, and it wasn't my fault because they count my wage really badly. So I think it wasn't happened for first time, and I feel that it's time to leave. That's bad, really, that's bad. It's always some changes like this are terrible. I'm so scared. So please wish me luck to deal with my life really well now, because I don't know what to do. I really don't know. Wow, it's terrible. But I hope, girls, that you will like your journals. They kind of show me that I'm gonna travel in my life again to new space, to new job. So please wish me luck to find something good, something where they will appreciate that I'm a good worker. And they will pay me for my work. Please, wish me luck. Thank you so much for all your support. I adore you. I hope you took some inspiration. Thank you so much for sharing your time with me today. Have a beautiful time. Take care about yourself. And see you next time. Bye.